Good morning, friends. Welcome back to the class after a long break. I hope you all are safe at home and healthy too. Now, coming to the next chapter, that is chapter number 5, Continuity and Differentiability. And this is the first chapter in the calculus branch, right? Where you have already know about the continuity means, right? Without lifting the pen, if you are able to draw the graph at a given point, the graph is said to be continuous. This has been already discussed through the language of limits in 11th standard. So let's recall what we have studied in 11th standard. What does mean by limit exist and limit does not exist? If limit exists, what does mean by continuity, right? Our continuous graph. Okay, so now what I am saying ki in this chapter, to understand the continuity, I am dividing this continuity topic into two sessions. The session number one, that is today's session, will be a introductory topic where we will just check the whether the function is continuous or not, nothing else. And the rest of the part means algebra of the continuity and the composition of continuity in the next session. So in this session, just we are going to understand what does mean by continuity and how to check the continuity of the graph at a given point. So let's recall the fundamental things which we have studied in the 11th standard in the chapter limits. So just I have illustrated here three different graphs just to get the intuition about the continuity of the graph. So in general language, we know what is meant by continuous graph. Continuous means without any break or gap, if you are able to draw the graph of the given function at a given point, hence the graph is said to be continuous. So here, if you observe the figure number one, that is graph number one, to draw this graph, you need to lift the pen. Means, let us say this graph here, left portion is moving towards minus one, towards negative infinity, and here it is approaching towards positive infinity, let us say. Or we can also say when x is approaching zero, the function is approaching two different values. I'm dealing with both the languages. One is simple graph and the function nature. And then I will try to connect that definition with the limiting language. The first, if you observe the graph, this graph is not continuous. There is a break, right? And this can be identified the same from the given function. This is a function defined, right? When x is greater than 0, the function is approaching 1. When x is less than or equal to 0, function is approaching minus 1. This is a given function whose graph is looks like this. So from the graph, you can easily identify, yes, graph is not continuous. But the same thing can also be discussed or analyzed from the given function. If x, that is function, is approaching 1, when x is approaching 0 from positive side, or when x is approaching 0 from negative side, the function is approaching minus 1. Hence, here this graph is said to be discontinuous graph. In this case, what happened? The left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. If you find the limit of this function by using the left hand limit and right hand limit, these two are not equal. Hence, the graph is said to be not continuous. Or also you can say the limit does not exist. Limit does not exist means the function is moving in two directions. Half of the graph is moving left hand side and the half of the graph is moving right hand side. Hence the graph cannot be continuous. Second case, if you see the graph of this function, there is only one single gap at exactly x is equal to 0. So since the function is defined like this, graph is looking like this. It means when x is not equal to 0, function approaches 1. When x is equal to 0, function is approaches 2. So according to the function, the graph is looks like this. X is not equal to 0 means either x is less than 0 or greater than 0. Means left hand limit and right hand limit functions are approaching 1. And when the function value is exactly at 0, the value of the function is 2. So limiting language means left hand limit, right hand limit both are approaching the same value, right? But exactly at x is equal to 0, function is approaching 2. Hence, left hand limit, right hand limit are same, are equal, but the value of the function at 0 is not equal. Hence, what we call limit is exist, but still the value of the function is not same, hence the function is not continuous. So there are two major things where we can say the graph is not continuous. First one, the left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. It means that graph is moving in two directions, means half of the graph is moving left hand side, half of the graph is moving right hand side in opposite direction. Limit does not exist, graph is not continuous. The second case may arise. Your limits must be same, but it may not be equal to the value of the function at a given point. Hence, the graph is said to be what? Not continuous. Limit exists, but graph is not continuous. In that case, the graph is looks like this. Means graph will be a continuous except that point. Hence, for given point, graph is said to be discontinuous. Now the third point, where you will see the graph, the complete graph, without lifting the pen, you can retrace this graph. How it happens? The function is defined like that, means at x is equal to 0, means when the value of the function at 0, the value is 0. Even the value of the function is greater than 1 or less than 1, greater than 0 or less than 0. For every value around 0, the value is what the function and the limit of the function all are approaching the same value. It means that left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to value of the function. If all the three parts are equal to each other, then the graph is said to be continuous if x is equal to 0. So only three points you need to remember. Where by solving the question, you may get the three different points. Either you may approach like left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, first case. In this case, you will simply declare the graph limit is does not exist, hence it is not continuous. Second case, where the limits are equal, left hand limit becomes right hand limit but not equal to the value of the function. In that case, it is said to be not continuous graph. Our limit exists but not equal to value of the function, it is not continuous. Third case, where the left hand limit, right hand limit, value of the function all are equal to each other, then there we can say the graph is continuous at a given point. So this is what the simple theory where you need generally approaching while solving the questions. What does it mean? Graphically you can see. Also, only the case where the graph is said to be continuous at a given point, if and only if the left hand limit, right hand limit are simply limit of the function and the value of the function both must be coincide. Then only you can say the graph is continuous. So to understand the same, we are going to take few sums, 4 to 5 sums I am going to take, where you will see all the cases one after the other. Okay, so let's have a discussion on that. So I'm just erasing this one because we are focusing only on continuity in the session 1 as well as in session 2. We will then thereafter we introduce the differentiability, because it's the second part of this chapter. Okay. So now I'm taking the textual question here from exercise 5.1. From exercise 5.1, NCERT based questions I'm taking. am taking the question number 1, where we need to check the continuity of this function f of x is equal to 5x minus 3. Check the continuity at x is equal to, let us say, x 0. We need to check this continuity of this function at x is equal to 0, right? So to check this, first we'll find the limit of this function and then we'll find the value of the function. If limit of the function, value of the function, both are same, then the function is said to be continuous. For that, first we'll find the limit of the function. Limit of the function at x tends to what? We are checking the continuity at 0. That's why we are taking x tends to 0. What does it mean? Here we are having only one single function. That's why I'm directly taking the limit value. Limit, what is the function given? 5x minus 3, x is tends to 0, and then simply substitute this 0 in the function. Hence, what you will say? 5 into 0 minus 3, answer is minus 3. This is the limit value of the function. Done. Hence, now we are taking the value of the function. What is the function? First, f of x is equal to 5x minus 3. Now directly we are substituting x is equal to 0 in the function. Hence this is called value of the function. So 5 into 0 minus 3, hence minus 3 is the answer. So what you will say here, this is what limit value and this is the value of the function. So we are saying therefore limit of the function as x is tends to 0 is equal to the value of the function at 0, that is f of 0, both are equal and both are equal to minus 3. Therefore, the graph is what? Continuous at x is equal to 0. I think it is so simple. This we were doing since so long. Kaafi saalo se hum karte aa rahe hain. Just value of the function find karna hai, whatever the point where we are checking the continuity. So this is, will always give the value of the function at particular point. And limit value gives what? If I am calculating the limit, means I am talking about left and as well as right hand limit. Why I can do this directly in this way? Because we are having only one single function. Okay. So this is a way, limit of the function, value of the function, both are same, both are approaching the same value, hence limit of the function, value of the function are same, hence the graph is said to be continuous. You may also realize the same, if you take the points around 0, 0 say, kam ya 0 say zyada, like you can take some points which are less than 0, means minus 0.5, minus 0.7, minus 0.6, like this, and then from right hand side 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. If you take that values around 0 and substitute them in the function to get the points and then plot those points on the graph, by joining them you will see the graph will be continuous at x is equal to 0. So you can realize the same through a graph, but it will become a tedious task and time consuming process. Hence, we are using the limiting language to check the continuity of the graph at a given point. Now I am taking some more questions, right, where you will see the difference in the solution part. Now, I am taking the question number 2 from the textbook itself. The function is x square minus 1. The function is, check the continuity of the graph, minus, let us say it is minus 3 at x is equal to 2. So what they are asking, check whether this function is continuous or not at x is equal to 2. Again, simple, we are having only single function. Hence, we can go through the simple method. First, we'll find the limit of the function, and then we'll find the value of the function. If both are same, we can say continuous at x is equal to 2. So first, we'll find limit. Limit of the function at x is tends to 2. When I say limit, it is not equal to 2. It is basically x is tends to 2. It is not exactly 2. Either it is less than 2 or more than 2. This is the meaning of limit of the function. So limit x tends to 2. What is the function we have? 2x square minus 3. And simply substitute this limit now in the function. 2 into 2 square minus 3. The answer would be what? 4 to the 8. 8 minus 3, that is 5. And thereafter, now take the value of the function. F of x is what? 2x square minus 3. Now we are checking it continuity at 2. That's why I'm directly substituting the value of the x in the function. And it is called value of the function at 2. It remains same, that is 5. So hence what we can say, therefore, limit of the function as x is tends to 2 is equal to the value of the function, that is f of 2. Both are equal to 5. Therefore, graph is continuous at x is equal to 2. X is equal to 2, but the graph is always continuous. And as you know, quadratic means degree 2 it is. So quadratic function graph is always a parabola, right? It is always a continuous, whether it is upward or downward, left side or right headed parabola at any given point. So hence it is continuous. Now I am taking some more question. Here I am taking the question number 5, which is very important. Now they are asking, just to read the question carefully, is the function, fifth one, is the function f defined by, is the function f of x is equal to x, where if x is less than or equal to 1 and it approaches 5 if x is greater than 1, is continuous at x is equal to, continuous at x is equal to 0, question mark, at x is equal to 1, question mark, at x is equal to 2 is a question mark. It's beautifully framed. See, what they are asking, this is a function. First of all, you can see there are two different values the function is approaching according to the value of the x. If the value of the x is less than or equal to 1, then function is approaching x, or function is x. When x is greater than 1, the function value is 5. So this is given. Now we need to check the continuity of this graph at three different points. Means we are having three questions, three sub questions in a main question. Right? So we'll solve one after the other. We'll go with first x is equal to 0. We'll check the continuity of the graph at x is equal to 0. Thereafter, as a part 2, we'll check at 1, and one as a part 3, we'll check at x is equal to 2. So I'm taking first x is equal to 0. How it will looks like? See. Now I'm taking the case 1. Case 1 means, where we'll check the continuity at x is equal to 0. So first we'll find the limit of the function. Okay. So you can see the limit, we are having two different functions. Hence we need to take left hand limit as well as right hand limit. right? In the previous two questions, we were having only single function, so we can directly proceed with the limit question, so the limit simple language without taking left and right. But where it comes, where you are having the more than one option of the function, right? Our function is defining various forms. There you need to take left hand limit as well as right hand limit. Now for that, first we'll take the left hand limit, right hand limit, and then we'll find the value of the function. If all the cases are same, the function is said to be continuous, otherwise not. Now at x is equal to 0, left hand limit, and let me be left hand. What is the format? You know already 11th standard you have done so many questions based on this. Now for left hand limit, what is the format? First, limit of the function when x is approaching a constant from left hand side. This is the format, and we are checking at 0. That's why we are writing first in a format like limit of the function when x is approaching 0 from left hand side. Now just take the function from the question. When x is approaching 0 from left hand side means the value of x is less than 0. Where it comes? Here. Because here this function is valid for all the values which is less than 1. So just for your knowledge, I am just analyzing this. So here this function says, let us say it is 1. Okay. So if the value of the function means when x is less than or equal to 1, function would be x, that is f of x would be taken as x. Now if the value of the function is moving like x is greater than 1, means for this region the function would be 5. This is the meaning of the given function. But what we are doing, we are checking the continuity of the function at 0. It means that where 0 comes, if I plot this on the number line, the left hand side of the 1 means this is will be a 0 or not. Correct? So whatever the values left hand side of 0 are right hand side of the 0, all the values including 0 coming in this region, hence for left hand side limit, right hand side limit, value of the function, for all these, right, x is equal to 0, around x is equal to 0, function would be only x. Okay, so for that, what I took here, the function f of x is what? X. For all x less than or equal to 0, the function would be x. Now what we will do, we will simply replacing like h tends to 0, and it's always same, always h tends to 0 thereafter, and the value of x should be replaced with 0 minus h, right? Means whatever the value of x you are taking, that is definitely less than 0 only. So 0 say hum chota chota value liye. So how, what the value we are substituting? 0 minus h, nothing else. So that gap h tends to 0, then 0 minus h. So ultimately what you are saying here, we are left with only minus h. If you substitute the limit value of h in this question, sorry, in this function, you are approaching 0. This is a left hand side limit. Now to find the archer, that is right hand side limit. Again, the format, you have to write limit of the function when x is approaching the constant from right hand side, means which is more than that constant. So simply we are checking the continuity at 0, hence it should be x is tends to 0 from right hand side. So means x is just greater than 0, hence, but still this is coming in this range, that's why the function would be remain same, that is x. This is the function. Now we are moving to the writing like h tends to 0, that gap is tends to 0, and in place of x we are writing 0 plus h, means whatever the value of x we are substituting, that is definitely just greater than 0, that is 0 plus h value. Now we can substitute the limit value here to get the answer, that is 0. So here the approach is left hand limit is equal to right hand limit, means limit is exist. Now we need to check the third part, value of the function. So function is x and x is equal to 0. So hence we are substituting f of 0 directly to get the answer would be 0. Here what we say, left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to value of the function, all are equal to 0. Therefore, graph is said to be continuous at x is equal to 0. But friends, already we have discussed these questions in 11th standard. This part is regular for you. Only I have joined this part in 12th standard to just to say it is continuous or not. Clear? So this is the first part is done. Now I am taking the second part at x is equal to 1. Let's see. Now at x is equal to 1. So we are checking the continuity of the graph. Now at x is equal to 1. So to check as a case 1, now at x is equal to 1, what will happen? You know, this is a question mark, you know. Now to check this again, we are going for left hand limit, LHL, and then we'll find RHL. Then we'll go for the value of the function, that is f of 1. These are the three parts. So left hand side limit means limit of the function f of x at x is equal to a minus. This is the format. And then we'll write, and at what constant we are checking the continuity? At 1. So that's why we are writing limit x tends to 1 from left hand side. So means the value of the function less than 1. So value of the function less than 1. The function would be x. And then then modify this limit like limit x tends to 0. It is always h tends to 0 irrespective of the constant where you are checking the continuity. H tends to 0, and the value of x is what we are all taking the value of x which are less than 1. So ultimately value of x is 1 minus h, and then substitute the value of h as 0 in the question, you will get 1. Similarly RHL, for that the format would be limit of the function where x is tends to a plus. So to check again, which value we are taking? Limit x tends to 1 plus means more than 1. So where x is greater than 1, more than 1, the function is 5. Hence the function is 5. Here again we are modifying the limit. Limit h tends to 0, then the value of there is no x, hence the constant will remain same, and no h is there to substitute, constant will remain constant. Here if you observe, left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. Here only you can say limit does not exist and graph is not continuous at x is equal to 1. But still, for our satisfaction, we are also calculating the value of the function, that is f of 1. Now to check f of 1, first we need to take the function. Which function will come at exactly 1, where x equal to 1. X equal to 1, the function is this. Right? So where we are substituting 1 in the question, answer is 1. So if you observe, LHL is not equal to RHL. So no need to check the value of the function, it is just for our satisfaction we are calculating. We can say the graph is now not continuous at x is equal to 1. So graph was continuous at 0 but not continuous at 1. Now what left? To check x is equal to 2. So we are taking at x is equal to 2 now. I'm just not erasing the format of the graph. What will happen if I want to check the continuity of the graph at x is equal to 2, right? To check this, again, left hand limit, right hand limit, and value of the function, right? So first limit x tends to it, which constant we are talking about? 2. So it would be 2 minus means less than 2. So if you plot 2 on the number line, where it comes? After 1 only. Here 2 will come or not? Getting? So just less than 2 means this range and just greater than 2. So this entire range is coming on the right hand side of the 1, means if you are taking the points less than 2 or greater than 2 or exactly at 2, all these points around these 2 are coming on the right hand side part where x is greater than 1, means only this function is sufficient. Okay, so that is why the function would be here 5 will be taken where x is greater than 2. Sorry, x is approaching 2 from left hand side. Now we are changing the language. H tends to 0 and there is no x to substitute the value, hence 5 remains 5 only. The answer is 5. Similarly, here right hand side. So what we are taking? Limit x tends to 2 plus function will be 5, because already we have discussed. Now if you change that limit into what? H tends to 0, this would be 5 only. So finally answer is 5. And the value of the function, if we talk about f of x, would be 5. At x is equal to 2 we are talking about, that is f of 2 remains 5 only. So what we call left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to value of the function. All are equal to 5, therefore graph is continuous at x is equal to 2. So here at x is equal to 2 it is continuous. Now what does it mean in this question? The same function, the given function, is continuous at particular point and it is not continuous at particular point. So whenever we discuss the continuity of the graph, we mean to say the continuity of the graph at particular point, not in the entire domain of the function, remember, right? So here at 0 it's continuous, at x is equal to 1 it's not continuous, means there is a gap in the graph, there is a hole in the graph, and at x is equal to 2 graph is again continuous. So the same graph may continuous, may not continuous at a given point. So this continuity will be checked in this manner by finding the left hand limit, right hand limit, and the value of the function. Getting my point? So now to understand more, I am taking one more question, right, where we'll have some interesting points to discuss. The question number 7, it is given again the function just mod x plus 3 minus 2x and 6x plus 2. Function is defined in three ways, where if x is less than or equal to minus 3, where if minus 3 is less than x less than 3, where if x is greater than or equal to 3. We need to check the continuity of this graph nothing else. They does not define where we need to check the continuity. The point is not clearly defined. But if we observe this function, they are giving the limits of x, right? For minus 3 as well as for 3. You have x is less than or equal to minus 3, x is greater than minus 3. You have x is less than 3, you have x is greater than plus 3. Means you can check this continuity of the graph at two different points, at x is equal to minus 3 and at x is equal to 3. So there may be a two cases arises according to the given function, because we are having the function where x is less than minus 3, greater than minus 3. Similarly, where x is less than 3 and greater than 3. That is why we can check the continuity of the graph at two distinct points. Hence, the two cases will arise. Just like in the previous question, they were defining where we need to check the continuity. But in this question, they are not defining the point where we need to check the continuity. We are ourselves finding the point where we can check the continuity. So we concluded here the two different points where we can check the continuity, that from the question. So the case may first one, case one, where we are checking the continuity at x is equal to minus 3. For that, again, left hand limit, right hand limit, and the value of the function at minus 3. Three parts will come. Again, the format would be fixed. Limit x tends to what we are talking about, less than minus 3. So I'm direct writing that minus 3 minus means the value of x is just less than minus 3. So when the function is less than minus 3, which function would be taken? Modulus function plus 3. And simply then replace this limit, like limit always h tends to 0, that gap is tends to 0, and the value of x is less than minus 3, hence the modulus function mein kya substitute hoga? Minus 3 minus h, less than minus 3. H is very small positive integer, small positive real number, plus 3, and then substitute the value of h in the question. So value of h is what? 0. Simply substitute 0 here. So what you will left with? Minus 3 and plus 3, and modulus of minus 3 is plus 3 only. Modulus of every value is positive only. So answer would be 6. This is left hand limit of the function. And right hand limit, what we are taking? Limit x is tends to minus 3, right hand side. See, minus 3 plus means the value of x is just greater than minus 3. For that, we need to take the function where the function is greater than minus 3. X is greater than minus 3. See, x is greater than minus 3 here. It means the function is this, minus 2x. Now, substitute the here h language, that is h tends to 0. Then minus 2 into, in place of x, what will substitute? Minus 3 plus h. Minus 3 plus h, because the value of x is just greater than minus 3. Now, a value of h will be 0 in the question. So, simply substitute the value of h is 0. So, you are left with minus 2 into minus 3. Answer would be plus 6. And then coming to the value of the function. Okay, so what is the value of the function here? F of minus 3 means where exactly x is equal to minus 3, x equal to sine, x equal to minus 3, the value of this is a function where we need to substitute. Okay, so modulus function mein x replace to minus 3 substitute karenge. So what you will get? It has positive 3, hence the answer would be 6. So left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to value of the function, all are equal to 6. Therefore, graph is continuous at x is equal to minus 3. This is the case 1 is over. We have checked the continuity of the graph at x is equal to minus 3. Now, in the same manner, we are going to check the continuity of this graph at x is equal to positive 3. Okay, so now just I am keeping the question same. I am just removing this portion and again will solve for x is equal to 3. The case is now at x is equal to 3 we are talking about. Again, we will find left hand limit, right hand limit and the value of the function. So, left hand limit, right hand limit, value of the function. Okay. First, we will find left hand limit. Again, the same language, limit x is limit of the function when x is tends to 3 from left hand side or just less than 3. So, when x is just less than 3, function is minus 2x. This I am solving first this one. So, limit h tends to 0 minus 2 into in place of x, what will substitute? 3 minus h, just less than 3. Now, if we substitute 0 in the function thereafter, so we are left with minus 2 into 3, answer is here minus 6. And for the right hand limit, so limit of the function when x is tends to 3 from right hand side, when x is greater than 3, what is the function we have? 6x plus 2, and then now what we are changing, h is tends to 0, in place of x we are substituting what? 3 plus h plus 2, and then substitute the value of h is 0. Remember, this h is always tends to 0. H must to be, the value of h must to be 0, can be substituted over here. Hence, what we called as here 6 into 3 plus 2. Hence, what we called here 18 plus 2, this is 20. So you can easily see here, left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. So no need to check the value of the function. You can also say here, left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. Hence, graph is not continuous. Graph is not continuous at x is equal to 3. So, here what we understood, the same function may be continuous and may not be continuous depending on the point where we are checking the continuity. In the case 1, we were discussing the continuity of the graph at minus 3 and we found all the three parts were same, hence the graph was continuous, we declared, we deduced. But in the case 2, when we are checking the same function, the continuity of the function at different point, that is at 3, positive 3, we got the answer like left hand limit value is minus 6, right hand limit value is 20. Hence, these two are not equal. Limit does not exist. So, simply you can say, yes, it is not continuous at x is equal to 3. So, this is the way to check the continuity of the graph at a given point. So, in this manner, you may solve several questions from the exercise 5.1 wherever it is being asked to check the continuity of the graph. So, just for your time information, I will tell you from which question to which question from NCERT you can finish it off after watching this session 1. From question number 1, to question number 16, again I am speaking here, from question number 1 to 16 means we are having 16 questions in a sequence where you can finish the topic after watching this video carefully. Just you need to follow the steps which we were using step by step. So friends, here you can wind up the class here. After watching this video, please try to solve these 16 questions thoroughly one after the other to just get into the concept. If you are thorough in this topic, then only we can understand the session 2 in a perfect manner. Okay, where we will discuss the extension of this topic, means various concepts apart from the simple continuity of the graph. So thank you for watching this session, and keep watching, keep learning, and keep growing. So stay at home, stay healthy, and bye bye.